Ever since the Eco Lifestyle trailer dropped, I was excited for all the wooden stuff. The planters, the candle making station, the bug farm. There was just so much that inspired me, but one thing in particular caught my eye. The birdhouse. And so I made a giant one. Together with some other ideas, as well as this gorgeous work by Crooked Creation Birdhouses, this was just the perfect opportunity to finally tackle a house in the trees. But without further ado, let's get into building. So, you may wonder where this voice is coming from, but I can assure you, yes, the day has come. Over a year and 28 videos later, I finally did a voiceover. So, hi guys! I'm Sadie and I love to create fantasy stuff in The Sims 4, so I hope you'll enjoy a bit of commentary and explanation throughout the process, and I will start with that right now. As you can see, I'm currently working out the basic shapes of the building. As I mentioned in the intro, I used an existing birdhouse as a main inspiration, so I just tried to get the same unusual shape as my reference has. What I'm doing here is something that I learned in a tutorial by the lovely Kate Emerald. Basically, it's just you raise two levels to the heat you want them, and then you connect them with dragging a wall you place on the base level of the building. So I doubt that made any sense, so I will just drop the link to Kate's video in the description box and you can check that out if you want to learn how to actually connect two different levels together. Now I'm painting in some roofs, and of course I first went with the light blue swatch, because that's just something I do. Going with the blues and the teals and all that kind of stuff is really right down my alley, so at first I went with the blue swatch and as well blue wallpaper. But spoiler alert, I will change that later on. Then I tried to figure out which wallpapers I would go with, and that was kind of a tricky one, because I didn't really know which kind of material the house itself is supposed to have. But I pretty quickly settled on the wooden planks of the Island Living Pack, because I just love how you can variate them in color. I love how you can make kind of an ombre effect with it. Making a crooked roof like here in the back of the building is actually pretty easy. You just have to place down two half gabled roofs and then you bend inwards, the other one outwards, or you really just bend them in whatever shape you need them. Next up is placing down some windows and doors, and I went with base game doors and windows from Strangerville and Cats and Dogs. And with that I really just again stayed in my comfort zone, because thinking back I think I used the Strangerville windows in every single build of mine. I don't need any more windows, just give me those and I'm happy, really. Then I actually added back the first level, because I realized I need it. Added the stilt foundation, added the different shades of color of the wallpaper. Just overall making sure it fits to the levels above. and making sure the roof is not sticking into my room like that, because we don't want that. It's not very pleasing. Thank you. Now I'm creating my favorite part of the build probably, which is a staircase made out of chairs. And this is actually inspired by a children's show called Löwenzahn from the 90s. And the host of this show was actually living in a trailer, and his trailer had all kinds of weird inventions because he was a weird tinkerer. This trailer also had this staircase made out of chairs, so that's where the inspiration for this comes from. And of course, this is not functional, this is just decorational. And then another item from Island Living comes in, and that being the fence. After a little look at some of the new objects, as well as placing down the birdhouse on top, I started thinking about how a sim will actually get into this, so I started to add ladders. I am so excited that we now have ladders. It just makes me so much more comfortable to build in all kinds of heats. We can now even make the tiniest areas accessible, which is just, it's amazing. I'm doing something I mentioned earlier, and I switched all the blue tones to more of a greenish tone. I just think that fits more to the eco feel and ties in with the bushes I will place with the tree, and just is more natural, so I went with the green swatches. And for the rest of the video, it's really just decorational stuff and placing debug objects. And for this placement, I make heavy usage of the tool mod by Twisted Maxi. This mod allows you to rotate objects in whichever direction you want. It allows you to elevate objects by decimals even. And even though it may not sound as exciting when I try to explain it, it literally changed the game for me, and I know for many others too. And I don't wanna get too much into detail with how this works, but I'll add Twisted Maxi's page and a tutorial by Kate in the description box down below. For now, I'll just let you enjoy the last bits of building and then tune in again at the end. Have fun! Now comes a little slideshow of the interior, starting with the entrance area. I used a room I made a few weeks ago, and so I didn't really have to do anything for the entrance. I just had to place this cupboard there and call it a wrap, really. On the second level, I made the living area, including the new candle making station, and also a cooking area and kind of a chill area with a fireplace. And on the third and last level, I made really just a simple bedroom for one sim, nothing fancy, just something a sim can go sleep in. That's pretty much it. And with that, I'll finish off this video. I really hope you enjoyed watching. And also let me know if you like this kind of commentary, or if you prefer the videos with no voiceovers, just some chill music behind it. Let me know what you prefer. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope I'll see you next time. Bye!